Here is problem number 1.333 from hydrodynamics of fluid mechanics. In this question, it is given that a fluid with viscosity eta fills the space between two coaxial cylinders of radii R1 and R2 with R1 less than R2. The inner cylinder is stationary while the outer one is rotating with a constant angular velocity omega naught. The fluid flow is laminar, taking into account the friction force acting on unit area of a cylinder surface of radius r is defined by the formula sigma equal to eta r d omega with respect to dr. Find the angular velocity of the rotating fluid as a function of radius r. B, the moment of frictional forces acting on the unit length of the outer cylinder. So let's solve this question. So first, let the area of cross section, find the area of the curved surface of the cylinders. So area will be A equal to 2 pi r l, where r is the radius and l is the length of the cylinder. Now viscous force is defined as viscous force F will be equal to eta A r d omega with respect to dr. So if we substitute the value of A, then we'll find F equal to eta 2 pi r l into r d omega with respect to dr. From this equation, we can write force of friction will be equal to this friction of viscous force will be equal to 2 pi l r square d omega with respect to dr. Now torque tau will be equal to r into F. That will be equal to 2 pi eta l r cube d omega with respect to dr. Now if we integrate this, then we'll find tau into dr with divided by r cube is equal to 2 pi eta l d omega. Now we have to integrate both side. If we integrate both side, from the range of r, lower limit of r is equal to r1 and upper limit is small r, and lower limit of omega is 0 and upper limit is omega. So after integrating this quantity, we will find 2 pi l eta omega equal to tau divided by 2 into 1 divided by r1 square minus 1 divided by small r square. So let's, this is our equation number 1. But at r equal to r2, omega equal to omega 2. After putting the values, we'll get 2 pi l eta omega 2 will be equal to tau divided by 2 into 1 divided by r1 square minus 1 divided by small r square. So let these are equation number 2. So putting the value of tau in equation number 1, putting the value of tau in equation 1, we will get omega is equal to omega 2 into r1 divided by r2 square minus r1 square multiplied by 1 divided by r1 square minus 1 divided by small r square. So this is our required value of angular velocity. angular velocity. This represents the angular velocity. Angular velocity. Now we have to find. So this was our solution of part A, and for solution of part B, moment of friction per unit length is given by moment of friction per unit length is given by tau divided by L, which will be equal to 4 pi eta omega naught r1 r2 squared divided by r2 square minus r1 square. So this is the required value for moment of friction per unit length. The value for finding the moment of friction for unit length.